Why do we pursue healing?
我们为什么要追求医治？
When we hear our song over and over and over again,
当我们听到我们自己的生命之歌不断的重复的时候，
we embrace the truth of who we are.
我们会拥抱我们是谁的真理。
So let's look at a definition of trauma. A good way to define trauma is something that happens to us that is beyond our control, that causes us to feel intense fear, horror, or a sense of helplessness, or wounds us so deeply it seems that we've lost the ability to feel. And the first one that we'll look at today is fear-based trauma. Another type of trauma is physical trauma, sudden physical assault,And another type of really serious trauma is betrayal trauma. And this is when someone we need to trust. Another type of trauma is loss trauma. And that can include sudden, unexpected death. Emotional trauma is a huge kind of trauma. Another type of trauma is prejudice and injustice. This lesson is the devastating effects of trauma.
我们今天现在要上的课是创伤的破坏性影响。
And you know there's a scripture,
一段经文
in Proverbs 15:13,
箴言十五十三
that says this.
他是说，聪明人心求知识，愚昧人口吃余味。喜乐的心使人脸上容光焕发，心中愁苦使人精神颓丧。
Heartache crushes the spirit.
心痛会压迫我们的灵。
And that word spirit is a Hebrew word ruah.
那这个灵这个字呢，在希伯来文里面叫 ruah.
And it means breath, spirit, courage.
它代表的是气息、精神、勇气。
So many times when we experience heartache and trauma,
所以很多时候当我们经历心痛跟创伤的时候，
it crushes our spirit.
它就压碎了我们的灵。
And it robs us literally of our breath.
它像是偷窃了我们的呼吸。
But also spiritually of that breath that is the spirit.
但那灵里面也偷走了我们灵里面的气息。
A crushed spirit affects us physically, emotionally, and spiritually.
压碎的灵会影响到我们的身、我们的心、我们的灵。
However, most people who have experienced trauma aren't aware of that.
但是很多人当他经历创伤的时候，他们并没有明白这一切。
And unfortunately, most people in the church are unaware of that as well.
那很不幸的呢，很多在教会里的人，他们也不明白这一点。
And how many of you have gone to someone for prayer?
那你们有没有人曾经有去找人帮你祷告？
And they've said, "Oh, it'll be okay. It'll be all right."
他们跟你讲说会没事的，会没事的。
Or someone has come to you and asked you how you are.
或是有人来问你说你还好吗？
And your heart is breaking inside.
你的心在里面已经在破裂着。
And you say, "Well, I'm fine."
你跟他说我很好。
We do it all the time, don't we?
我们是不是常常都有这样做？
Especially in church.
特别是在教会里面。
Because we want to be fine.
因为我们想要是很好的。
We want to look fine.
我们想要看起来很好。
And people expect us to be fine.
然后人们期望着我们是很好的。
Especially if we're leaders, right, pastors?
特别如果你是领袖，是吗，牧师们？
But you know what? Sometimes we're not just fine.
但是你知道，有的时候我们真的就是不是很好。
And we need to learn to look past those words.
我们需要学习，就是看是穿越这些话语。
And see the heart.
能看见心。
And oftentimes we need that courage to be able to share what's really going on inside.
那有的时候我们真的是需要有勇气来真正分享我们内心所经历的事情。
But if trauma robs us of the courage,
但是呢，如果说创伤剥夺了我们的勇气，
sometimes we just don't have the courage to do that.
有的时候我们真的就是没有勇气做这件事。
And that's when we begin to pursue people.
这就是我们开始去追随人。
And love people to life.
然后我们要把这些人爱回生命。
And just draw them to the love of the Father.
就把他们带进神的爱里面。
And the more we can understand about trauma and how it affects us,
我们越明白关于创伤，还有创伤如何的影响我们，
the more effectively that we can minister to people.
让我们的施工会更有效。
And so we all respond differently to people. We do that too. We all respond differently to trauma.
我们的每一个人对创伤的反应都是不同的。
A lot depends on our temperament.
那很多时候是关于我们自己的个性。
Shy people,
害羞的人
，burden bearers,
那些那个背负包袱的人
，or people with identity issues,
或是他们有认知认同的问题
，oftentimes respond to trauma far greater than others.
他们有时候对于创伤的回应是超是强烈于别人的反应。
Now when I was praying this morning,
我今天早上在祷告的时候
，I was thinking about shyness.
我就讲到那个害羞。
And you know it's okay to be shy. Did you know that?
你知道是可以做害羞的人吗
？Yeah, it's wonderful.
是很好的。
But sometimes our shyness is a result of wounding.
但是有的时候我们那个害羞是来自于受伤。
And sometimes the dynamics of a family will drive a child inward.
有的时候，因为家庭里面的角色，每个人的关系会导致这个孩子往内在发展。
And I felt that there would be someone hearing this message today, and you are painfully shy.
然后我感觉到今天有人正在听这个讯息的，你是非常非常的害羞。
Not just kind of shy.
不是一般的害羞。
But so shy it hurts.
你很害羞，害羞到你的痛。
And you're afraid to speak in front of people.
你很害怕在人面前说话。
Or to sing in front of people.
或在人面前唱歌。
And it really is hindering you in your Christian walk.
它真的是阻碍了你在你的这个基督徒的旅程上进行。
And in your career.
还在你的事业上。
And I believe that this is a word for you.
我相信这个话语是对你说的。
That the Lord wants to heal you today.
主今天就要医治你
And to heal that pain and shame that you've carried for so long.
去医治你长久以来一直带着羞耻和伤痛
And to release you into who you really are.
去释放你成为你真正要成为的那个人
So Lord, we come into agreement with that.
所以主啊，我们同意所说的话
And Holy Spirit, we pray that you would break the power of darkness.
圣灵，求你要破除那个黑暗权势的力量。
That has kept this person in this, it's like a prison.
他已经把这个人好像囚固在一个监牢里。
And we declare freedom today.
我们今天要宣告自由。
Freedom to speak.
还有自由说话。
And to sing.
自由唱歌。
And to enjoy life.
自由去享受生命。
And we declare the power of the painful shyness broken in Jesus' name.
我们要奉主耶稣名宣告今天那个。很痛苦的害羞的要被破除
Amen
Amen
And a lot depends on the circumstances and age
那很多时候呢关于我们的环境还有我们的年龄
Now if we're about 15
如果差不多15岁
And our dad pushes us off the dock
然后呢我们的爸爸把我们从码头上推下去
And we go into the water
然后我们就跳到水里面去
We'll probably come up sputtering and get on the dock and push him off
我们可能就是爬上来，然后在岸上把水抖一抖之后呢，把他也推下去。
But someone told me their story when they were a little boy, 2 years old.
但是有人跟我说过他的故事，他是两岁的小男孩的时候。
Their father threw him into the water to teach him how to swim.
他的爸爸就把他丢到水里面去教他如何游泳。
He was traumatized.
他就受了创伤。
A lot depends on our resilience.
很多时候呢，看我们自己的韧性
，and that simply means our ability to bounce back or to spring back from bad things。
那个呢，就代表的是我们有的能力去从坏的事情恢复过来。
I was on the trampoline with my grandson。
我有次在跳跳床上跟我的孙子。
And he was getting a pretty good ride because grandma's a lot heavier than he is.
然后他跳得很开心，因为阿妈是体重比他大。
And I jump and he'd go, whoa!
我一跳他就飞起来了。
But I tripped one time and I went, oh!
结果我摔倒了，然后就 oh!
And he went, oh!
然后他也 oh!
And he said, grandma!
他说阿妈
You stole my bounce.
你偷走了我的那个跳跃。
I said I didn't even know you could do that.
然后我说我都不知道你可以做这样子的事。
But you know that's a good example.
你说这是一个很好的范本。
How trauma robs us of our bounds.
就是创伤会剥夺我们的生命的跳跃。
Our ability to spring back.
我们能够 恢复的能力
and to get over things quickly.
然后就很快的就去度过一些事情
A lot depends on our coping skills.
很多的时候也看我们适应的能力
And I believe that coping skills are learned.
那我相信那些适应的技巧是学习来的
We watch how mom and dad go through trauma.
我们会看着我们的父母亲经历创伤
We watch how they handle their anger.
那我们就会看着他们如何处理他们的愤怒
We watch how they cope with stress.
我们也看他如何适应他的压力
And so we learn how to do that.
然后我们就从他们那边学习
But how many of us had good examples of how to cope with things?
但是我们到底有多少个人是真正有很好的例子来看说我们如何去面对我们的愤怒呢
And many of us didn't learn how.
我们很多人都没有学习到
A lot depends on our prior history.
很多事情也关于说这个创伤发生之前我们的事情。
If you give me 50 pounds to carry,
如果你给我100公斤的东西来拿
I can carry that.
我可以抱得动。
But if I go over here and you give me 50 pounds to carry,
那如果过来你又再给我100公斤
that would be extremely difficult.
就很困难了。
But then if I go over here and somebody else gives me 50 pounds, I would be crushed.
那如果说我再过来这边又有一个人给了我100公斤的话我可能就被压扁了
So sometimes people will experience something as an adult
有些时候有些人会经历一些事情但是他们已经成人了
And it will absolutely crush them
但是还是会完全的压垮他
And we'll kind of look at them like why was that so big for you
那我们会就看着他说为什么这件事情对你来说这么严重呢
But usually we don't understand what they've been through.
但是我们通常并不明白他们之前经历过什么事。
And we do each other a disservice sometimes.
那有的时候我们并没有真正的尊重对方。
When we think you should be able to get over that.
啊，我们也会说你应该可以度过这个困难啊。
Or sometimes we'll say something like this.
或有的时候我们会这样说。
Oh, your operation sounds horrible.
Oh, 你的手术听起来非常的糟糕。
But let me tell you about mine.
那让我来告诉你我的手术。
Amen. We just, we don't have the sympathy or the compassion that we need.
我们没有那个同情心去给予他们所需要的。
And a lot depends how much care we received afterwards.
但是这个通常是关于到说我们到底我们受了创伤之后有得到多少照顾。
I was visiting my little grandson.
我那时候去看我的小孙子。
And he fell and skinned his knee.
然后他跌倒了，然后擦破皮。
And he came running to his mom and he was shaking and crying.
他就跑到他妈妈那边，他发抖然后哭。
And she just picked him up and held him.
他就把他抱起来。
And loved him.
爱他。
And pretty soon you could just see that trauma dissipate.
很快的你就可以看到那个创伤就消失了
And he just put his little head on her chest and went to sleep
然后他就把头放在他妈妈的胸口然后睡着了
And that's God's design, amen?
那就是神设计的 amen
When we go through things that people would love us and comfort us
当我们经历事情的时候呢人们会来爱我们会关怀我们
That we would be prayed for and have community around us
我们会有身边有一群团队，有一群团体会来帮我们祷告。
But you know what? Sometimes what happens?
但是你知道有的时候什么事情发生吗
？Is that the very people who should have brought comfort?
就是那些应该要来安慰你的人
，are the ones who are traumatizing.
但是他们就是受加于你创伤的人。
I was molested as a little girl at 3 years old.
我三岁的时候就被性骚扰
And I kept that secret for 50 years
我把这我被性侵害的秘密保留了50年
I didn't tell anybody
我没有告诉任何人
And so I carried the shame and the pain
所以我就带着那个羞耻还有痛
And I didn't receive the comfort of other people because they didn't know
我没有办法去领受别人来的安慰因为他们并不知道
There is a window of opportunity for trauma to be healed.
那有一个机会的之窗是可以让我们的创伤得到医治的。
Experts will say, experts in quote,
专家会这么说。
About 72 hours.
大概72小时。
And if the trauma is not resolved,
如果说这个创伤没有被处理到
it begins to settle within us.
它就会开始在我们心中沉淀
And it begins to affect us one way or another
它就会就任何一种形式开始影响我们
James McGaugh says this about memory
痛苦或是甜蜜的记忆并非事件之后即刻形成，而是经过时间的酝酿，好像水泥慢慢硬化。重要的是为事件祷告，要把握这机会之窗是在他们没有硬化之前。
So there's a window of opportunity for memories to、for the trauma to be released.
所以其实是有一个机会之窗，是让这个创伤能被释放的。
So that the memories will not be so traumatic.
所以这个记忆不会是那么的伤痛的。
David McCollum is a...works for the Department of Health in the U.S.
他在美国的卫生署工作。
And he says this about childhood trauma.
他对于孩童时代的创伤有这样子的解说。
It's at the heart of many of the leading causes of death and disability.
他说这个呢其实是在很多的死亡和残障的中心原因。
This is a government agency.
这是一个政府机关。
And they're recognizing the importance of early childhood trauma.
他们现在看到在儿童时代所受的创伤的重要性。
The American Institute of Stress,
在美国有一个机构，他们专门研究压力。
Says that 75% to 90%,
他们说有75%到90%
of all doctor visits are stress-related.
所有的去看医生的都是跟压力有关的。
Can you imagine if the church began being the church?
你可以想象，如果说教会开始成为教会
，and we begin to pray，
我们开始祷告
，and we begin to be instruments of peace，
我们开始带来平安。
Can you imagine the impact that we would have?
你可以想象我们有所有的震撼吗？
What would happen if 75% to 90% of people stopped going to the doctor because they were healed?
如果有那75%到90%的人，他们不再去找医生，因为他们已经得医治了。
Would we not have revival?
那我们是不是就有复兴呢？
Amen. And so let's look at some of the physical fruit.
好，那我们现在来看一下对身体上的果子。
In the church, we regularly pray for physical healing.
在教会里面，我们通常经常会帮身体上的不舒服祷告。
But I love what Peter Horobin says.
但是我很喜欢 Peter Horobin 说的，就是重要的是要为破碎的心祷告，不只是破碎的身体。身体无法完全医治愈合，同时也反映了不愈的创伤，仍有内心的疼痛。
So we need to learn to pray for the broken body, but also for the broken heart.
所以我们不只要学习着为身体上不舒服而祷告，我们也要为心的伤痛祷告。
Because many times the physical body,
因为很多时候我们身体的
is simply manifesting what's going on inside.
我们身体只是反映了我们内心所发生的事情。
And unfortunately, what we've been doing is throwing medicines at it.
很不幸的呢，我们只是懂得去服药，使用药。
And if that one doesn't work, let's try this one.
如果这个药物没有效，我们就试另外一个药。
When we cleaned out my mom and dad's cupboards,
当我清除我父母亲他们的医药箱的时候
，I was shocked at the medications.
我很震惊他们那些药的数量。
Church, we need to get hold of this.
教会，我们需要明白这一点。
To learn how to pray.
去学习如何祷告
，to learn how to minister，
去学习怎么去服侍
，and to learn how to come alongside people in their trauma，
所以去学习到在那些受到创伤的人身边陪他们
，and walk them to a place of peace，
带领着他们去到一个平安的地方。
Another common fruit of unresolved trauma，
还有一个通常没有处理的创伤的身体上的果子
，is that we're easily startled，
就是我们很容易惊吓。
And you know, in the states, we have the 4th of July.
你知道在美国有美国国庆就是7月4号
，a big celebration and fireworks and lots of food.
还有很大的庆祝，有烟火啊，还有很多的食物。
So I invited my sister to come to the celebration.
所以我就邀请了我的姐姐来庆祝。
And she said, "For you guys, it's a celebration."
她就对我说，她说对你们来说是一个庆祝。
But my husband was in Vietnam.
但是我的先生。以前在越南
and when he hears the sounds,
当他听到那个声音
And he smells the smell.
他闻到那个味道。
It triggers him right back into combat.
就会影响让他回忆到他以前在作战的时候。
And so we don't go to things like that.
所以我们不去参加任何这样子的活动。
Unexplained aches and pains.
没有办法解释的身体上的疼痛。
You know what they've discovered?
你知道他们发现什么？
There's a memory apparatus in every cell of our body.
在我们每一我们人的细胞里面，每一个细胞都有个记忆的的机构机制。
Isn't that amazing?
这是很神奇啊。
We can experience extreme weariness.
我们会经历到非常的不平安。
Or fibromyalgia.
纤维肌痛。
And it's like our organs have been stressed for so long.
好像我们体内的器官已经承受压力很久。
And in such a state of overload,
在我们没有办法负荷的时候
，that they simply give up.
他们就放弃了。
And I was at a conference in the UK.
我在英国参加了一个特会。
And there was a word of knowledge about someone being healed from fibromyalgia.
那时候就有一个知识的援引，说有人要从那个。纤维肌痛被得医治
，which is extremely rare for that to be healed.
因为那个要得医治是非常非常稀有的。
And nobody came forward.
然后没有人出来。
But later a man came forward.
结果过了一会儿有一个男人他往前来。
And he was up in the sound booth.
他原来是在声控的地方。
And he'd had prayer so often that he wasn't going to go down because nothing worked.
因为通常很多人都有帮他祷告过，所以他觉得不可能会有效的，所以他就没有上前来。
But then he thought, well, it couldn't hurt anything to respond.
然后他就想说，哇，我要回应他也不差嘛。
But he was hurting so bad, it took him so long to get down. We'd gone on to something else.
但是因为呢，他非常的疼痛，他花了很多的时间跟精力来到前面。那时候我们已经提到别的题目了。
But I prayed for him.
但是我为他祷告。
And the Lord gave a word of knowledge.
然后神给了我一个智慧的语言
that it was connected with the military service.
那是跟他之前在军队里的服事有关系的。
Now I didn't know he was in the military. I didn't know him.
我根本不认识他，我也不知道他曾经有在军队里待过。
But Holy Spirit knew him.
但是圣灵认识他。
And Holy Spirit touched that place within him where the trauma was.
但是圣灵就触摸了他之前接受创伤的地方
，and healed him，
嗯，医治了他
，but it didn't manifest right away。
但是他没有马上这个医治马上没有彰显
，so he kind of went back to the sound booth。
他就这样子回到那个声控的地方。
But a couple days later in church，
然后过了几天在教会
，he was sitting next to someone，
他就坐在一个人的旁边
，and the person said， I think I believe in healing。
然后这个人说，哦，我相信医治。
And this man said, "Yes, you're in the right place because we do too."
然后那个男人就跟坐他身边的人说：“是啊，我们也相信你来到了对的地方。”
And he said, "This warmth came over him."
然后他说，在那个当下，他身上就感觉到一股热流。
And he was healed of the fibromyalgia.
然后他的纤维肌痛就得医治了。
And the tinnitus in the ear, ringing in the ear.
他耳朵里面常常会听到的嗡嗡声。
And he went to his doctor.
然后他就去看医生。
And the doctor said, "You can't be healed."
医生说你不可能得医治的啦。
There's no cure for fibromyalgia.
因为这个是没有医治的。
He said, "But it is quite interesting that you're not taking your medicine anymore."
但是医生说这很有趣，你现在都没有再服用你的药物了。
He was taking pain medicine every 2 hours.
他是每隔两个小时要吃一个止痛药。
And he doesn't need any at all.
他现在完全不需要。
Isn't that amazing?
不是很神奇吗
？Inflammation, arthritis,
那些关节炎、发炎。
You know, arthritis can be, and I want to emphasize, can be.
关节炎，我要强调，关节炎可以。
Connected with bitterness and unforgiveness.
它可能是连接到很多的苦毒，还有不饶恕。
Again, do not put this in a box.
好，再一次不要把它是放在一个盒子里面。
And if someone has arthritis, tell them you must be bitter.
你不要碰到有人说我有关节痛，你就跟他说你一定是有苦毒。
Don't do that.
不要这样做。
But,
但是
we can ask.
我们可以问
Holy Spirit,
圣灵
Is there bitterness in me?
在我心中是不是有苦毒呢？
Am I angry?
我是不是有愤怒？
Have I forgiven the people who have traumatized me?
我有饶恕那些加于我创伤的人吗？
Just ask questions.
要问问题。
And it's the Holy Spirit's job to convict us of sin.
是圣灵的工作，去告提醒我们哪里有犯了罪。
So he's very happy when we ask him those questions.
所以圣灵很高兴我们问他问题的。
Headaches and migraines are very common.
头痛和偏头痛是非常普遍的。
And sinus problems.
甚至于鼻窦发炎。
I was ministering to a man, and he'd been part of gangs.
哦，我之前有服侍一个人，他之前有参加帮派。
And a lot of trauma.
然后很多戏剧。
And I asked him if I could pray for him.
那我问他说，我可以帮你祷告吗？
And he said, sure.
他说好啊。
And so a few days later, I called him and asked him what fruit came of the prayer.
然后呢，过了几天，我就打电话他，问他说，你有没有发觉什么果子啊？
And he said, I've had such sinus headaches all my life.
他说我一生都有因着我的鼻窦而引发的头痛。
I've hardly been able to function.
我都没有办法运作。
And he said, but since you prayed, I haven't had a sinus headache.
但是他说，自从你帮我祷告之后，我就没有一个鼻窦炎引发的头痛了。
And I used to have sinus headaches so bad I couldn't get up off the couch.
我之前的鼻塞头痛真的非常的严重，我根本没有办法起身。
But I had all these vows not to cry.
但是我有很多的誓言说我不可以哭。
And to be strong.
我要很强壮。
And not to let anybody hurt me that way again.
好，不要让任何人这样子来伤害我。
But when I broke those vows,
但是当我破除了那些誓言的时候
when I forgave,
当我原谅
my sinus headaches went away.
我的鼻塞头痛就没有了
I haven't had another one.
我就再也没有经历过
in probably 30 years.
差不多三十年了
TMJ,
颞下寒关节症候群
My friend had 6 operations on her jaw.
我的朋友有经历了六次手术，就是为了开了他的下巴。
So much pain, and they couldn't figure out what was wrong.
他有很疼痛，很多疼痛，但是他们不明白为什么。
And she was getting angry at God.
他就开始对神生气。
Because she was praying and believing.
因为他又在祷告，他也相信。
But God wasn't doing anything.
但是神并没有做任何事。
And so one day she went to a conference.
所以有一天他去了一个特会。
And as she was hearing the message.
当他在听那个教导的时候
she began to wonder,
他就开始想
Could my pain in my jaw be connected with the abuse I experienced as a child?
他就在想思考说有没有可能我经历的这些疼痛是可以连接到我儿童时代被虐待的关系
She had been abused by a grandfather
他被他的祖父虐待
But the real trauma came
但是真正的创伤来自于
when he told her, "Don't tell, it'll destroy the family."
当他跟他说，你不要让家人知道，这会破坏我们的家庭。
He was a leader in the church.
他是教会里的领袖。
And he said, "It'll destroy the church."
然后他说这样子也会毁坏教会。
So that little girl kept the family secret.
所以那个小女孩就为了家庭保守了这个秘密。
And that stress and tension.
然后那个压力还那个紧张。
And the abuse that affected this part of her body,
然后因为那个虐待哈，影响了到她身体的这个部分
settled in this area,
就在这个区域里面沉淀了
Now, was God concerned about her physical pain?
那当然，神有关心到她的身上的疼痛吗
Absolutely,
绝对的
But he was more concerned about her heart.
但是他更关心的是他的心
and the unforgiveness,
还有他的不饶恕
and the bitterness,
还有他的苦毒
and everything that she held against that grandfather,
还有所有他就是不原谅那个祖父的那些事情
That's why I love bringing this message.
这是为什么我这么的热爱我所带来这个讯息
Because I see light bulbs going off.
因为我就看到很多的灯泡好像亮了
and people going, oh, could it be?
然后就看到很多人的脸上的表情是哦，有可能吗
？To something that I went through，
有可能我经历的这些事情是因为我小的时候经历的某个创伤。
And I'm collecting a file of testimonies。
然后我现在呢，在收取很多人的见证。
It's just amazing，
真的是很神奇。
Reproductive difficulties，
生殖系统症状。
Endometriosis，
子宫内膜异位症。
Excessive menstrual bleeding or pain，
月经过量或者过度疼痛。
And infertility，
还有不孕症。
And one day at church, I was leaving for lunch.
有一天在教会的时候，我正要出去午餐。
And leaders, you understand about this.
领袖们，你们会明白这一点的。
You try and sneak out without anybody seeing you.
你就想要偷偷摸摸出去，然后不要让何人看到你。
I just want lunch, right?
他说我只想要去吃这个午餐。
But my friend stopped me and she says, Sandra, can you pray?
然后我的朋友他就停止了我，他说 Sandra, 你可以帮我祷告吗？
And she said, Josh and I are trying to have a baby, but we haven't been able to.
她说 Josh 跟我想要尝试有一个 baby 很久了，但是我们没有办法怀孕。
And we've been to a fertility specialist.
我们也去看了不孕症医生。
But can you pray?
但是你可以帮我们祷告吗？
And every grandma worth her salt.
每一个呢，值得的阿嬷呢，
loves a prayer like that. Amen.
很喜欢这样子的祷告。Amen.
And so I asked her if I could put my hand on her stomach.
那我就问她说，我可以把手放在你的肚子上吗？
And I began to pray.
我就开始为她祷告。
And I began to sense trauma deep within her.
然后我就感觉到呢，在她里面深深的地方有经历过创伤。
And so I simply asked the Lord to remove the trauma.
然后我只是就请求主把她的那个创伤挪去。
It wasn't a really long prayer.
不是个很长的祷告。
And so the next day she went back to her specialist.
然后就第二天她就去看那个不孕症医生。
And he gave her some medicine to take to start her cycle.
然后他就给她一些药，让她服了之后呢，去开始她的月经的运转。
But when she went back home, she didn't feel the release to take the medicine.
但是当她回到家的时候呢，她并不感觉说她想要去吃那些药。
And her husband agreed.
然后她的先生也同意。
And a week went by.
然后就一个礼拜过去。
And she started feeling not so good in the morning.
然后她早上开始就觉得不太舒服。
And another week.
又一个礼拜。
And another week.
又一个礼拜。
And so she went out and got a test.
然后就去买了一个那个验孕棒。
And it was positive.
然后结果是正的，是有怀孕的。
And she called her doctor.
她就打电话给她的医生。
And he says, oh no, those things are frequently wrong.
她说 no, 不是，这些东西常常是不准确的。
Take your medicine, start to cycle, and come in.
她说吃你的药，开始你的月经，然后进来看我。
But she didn't.
但是她没有。
And she waited.
她又等。
Took another test.
又再做一次验孕。
And it was like, wow.
他说：“哇、wow.
！”And so she went back to the doctor and she was pregnant.
所以她就去看医生，就发现她怀孕了。
And if she had taken that medicine, she would have aborted the baby.
但她那时候如果有服用医生的药的话，她可能就会堕掉了那个 baby.
And so this is a picture of little Layla.
所以这个就是小 Layla 的照片。
Sometimes the trauma can manifest in the cardiovascular system.
有些时候呢，这些创伤呢，会在我们的心血管系统、心脏。
I went with a friend to Salt Lake City.
我陪我一个朋友去那个盐湖城。
And it was one of the biggest heart transplant facilities in the U.S.
它是在美国里面是最大的心脏移植的机构。
And he was waiting to get on the heart transplant list.
然后他那时候就等待要能够排队去领取一个新的心脏。
And they assigned a counselor to us.
然后他们呢就分配给他一个辅导员。
And she said, "You need to be aware."
他就说你需要明白
that sometimes the people who receive the organ,
他说有的时候接受到那个器官的人
have the memory of the donor.
他们会有那个捐赠器官人的记忆。
That was freaky.
很可怕。
And I had heard that before, but I didn't believe it.
我之前有听过这样的事情，但是我并不完全相信。
But when there's a medical professional sitting in front of you,
但是当有一个医学专业人士坐在你的面前
and saying you need to be aware of this,
就跟你说你需要明白这件事
I began to think,
我就开始想
And I thought, how fearfully and wonderfully are we made?
我就想说，我们是多么的敬畏的，我们的被造是如何的敬畏的。
That an organ can be taken out of a dead person,
它是一个从一个死人的身上取得的器官
and transplanted into a live person，
移植到一个活人的身上。
And on occasion，
然后有时候
，they can access the memory，
他们可以去获得他的记忆。
Is that not amazing？
那不是很神奇吗
？And I believe God created us this way。
我相信神创造我们这样子。
So every cell of our body could be filled with the glory of God。
所以我们身上的每一个细胞都能够被神的荣耀充满。
So every cell of our body would be filled with the knowledge of God。
所以我们身上的每一个细胞都会充满了对神的认识。
But sometimes those cells are filled with trauma。
但是有的时候，那些细胞是充满了创伤的。
And we begin to manifest that trauma。
我们就会彰显那些创伤。
And this is a key。
这是一个很重要的。
You can command the cells to release the trauma to Jesus。
你可以命令这些细胞去释放这些创伤，把它交给主耶稣。
And be filled with once again with the glory。
你就可以再度的让这些细胞充满了神的荣耀。
Isn't that good news?
这不是个好消息吗？
It's amazing.
真的是很神奇。
Proverbs 17:22 says this.
箴言十七这样说：喜乐的心乃是良药，忧伤的灵使骨干枯干。
So what's in the bones?
所以我们在骨头里有什么
？The marrow.
骨髓。
And the marrow has to do with what?
那骨髓是跟什么有关的呢？
The immune system，
跟我们的免疫系统。
And so our immune system can be compromised，
所以我们的免疫系统是可以受到迫害的。
And oftentimes the spirit of infirmity gets a foothold，
当通常有这个生病的灵。
In Proverbs 18:14 it says this，
箴言十八十四说：人有疾病，心能忍耐；心灵忧伤，谁能承担呢？
And so sometimes we find ourselves constantly fighting infections and colds.
所以我们有的时候会发现我们自己常常是在不断的在感冒啊，或者是有感染。
And sometimes allergies can be connected.
所以有的时候过敏呢是可以连接到
with decisions that we've made as little kids.
是我们儿童时代所做的决定。
Life isn't safe.
人生是不平安的。
There'll be no nurture for me.
这里不会有任何的滋养的。
There'll be no comfort for me.
没有人会安慰我的。
And so the very things that are to give us nurture and comfort,
所以那个应该要给我们滋养还安慰的
，affect us negatively instead.
反而是负面的影响了我们。
Now again, just ask the question, Lord, could it be?
所以再度的，只是要问主这个问题，主啊，这有可能是。
Are my allergies connected with unresolved trauma?
我的这个过敏是不是跟我之前未处理的创伤有关系呢
？Long recovery times when we're sick.
有的恢复时间要很长。
Autoimmune diseases.
或者是我们自身免疫性疾病。
They're recognizing the connection with diabetes and self-hatred.
所以他们现在有开始做研究，发觉说自我憎恨跟糖尿病是有关联的。
And they're recognizing the connection between unresolved traumas and cancer.
然后他们也在发觉说，那未处理的创伤和癌症是有关联的。
Especially with breast cancer,
特别是乳癌。
Oftentimes there's issues with mom.
通常是跟妈妈有关系的。
Or issues with nurture,
或者是被滋养是有关系的。
The bowels are another area that are highly affected by trauma.
我们的排便、肠胃蠕动常常也是会被创伤影响的。
The bowels and the kidneys,
我们的肾脏还有我们的肠
are ways that we naturally get rid of waste.
但是我们身体很自然去解决那些排便排泄物的方法的地方。
So oftentimes the tension and the stress.
所以很多时候那些压力啊，那些紧张
，and the unresolved trauma，
还有那些未处理的创伤
，are manifested physically，
它是说透过我们的身体来彰显。
Those spiritual blockages that we have，
那些我们属灵上的阻碍的不通的地方
，can be manifested physically，
也有可能在我们的身体上彰显。
Stomach aches， especially in children，
尤其是孩子他们有肚子痛的时候。
Sometimes kids have a stomach ache because they don't want to go to school.
他们有的时候肚子痛是因为他们不想去上学。
But if your child continually has stomach aches,
但是如果你的孩子是一直不断的肚子痛
，you need to ask questions.
你就是要问问题了。
Trauma can settle in the sensory organs.
那这些创伤呢，也可以在我们的感官感觉器官里面。
The eyes,
眼睛
，it's like traumatic images are seared in your eyes.
就好像那些很令你受创伤的那些形象影像，一直在燃烧的在你的眼睛上面。
You see the image with your eyes open.
你眼睛张开，你也会看到这些影片。
And you see the image when you close your eyes.
你眼睛闭上，你还是看得到这些影像。
Or the ears with a backfire or a certain sound.
或者是你的耳朵，你会听到某些声音。
Or a certain smell.
或是某种味道
that triggers you back to the trauma.
会把你带回到你当初受创伤的时候。
Or the tongue with taste.
或者是你的舌头，你的味觉。
Did you know that your skin is the largest organ that you have?
你知道你的皮肤是你身上最大的器官吗？
Can you imagine the trauma that your skin absorbs?
你可以想象你的皮肤所感受到的那些创伤吗？
There are hundreds of touch receptors at the ends of your fingers alone.
在你的手指头的指端就有一百多个触觉上的接收器官。
And so, if you have like skin disease,
如果你有皮肤上的疾病
or somehow your skin is not normal,
或者是你的皮肤是不正常的
ask the Lord if your skin is manifesting internal unresolved trauma.
那你就可以问主说，是不是你的皮肤正在彰显一些你内在有的未处理过的创伤
Trauma can settle within our memory.
创伤呢，也可以在我们的记忆里面。
Again, with our conscious memory,
也在我们的有意识的记忆里
and our subconscious memory,
或是潜意识的记忆里
Like I said, I just had that little snippet of a memory.
就像我之前提过的，我只有一点点小小的记忆
I didn't know what it was.
但是我并不知道那是关于什么
But it kept repeating.
但是它一直在重复着
So I began to pay attention.
所以我就开始注意了
It can manifest through body memory.
它可以透过我们身体的记忆来彰显。
Even the things that our mind forgets,
就像我们的脑袋可能会忘记一些事
our body remembers.
但是我们的身体会记得的
Trauma can manifest in dreams.
这些创伤也可以在我们的梦里面做彰显
Now, sometimes your dream is because you've eaten pizza right before you went to bed.
有的时候你做梦可能是因为你睡觉前吃了一片很大的 pizza.
But sometimes it's something that's being worked out within you.
那有时候它很多是因为你们我们的内在有一些事情需要被处理。
I was at a tea party in Texas.
我在德州去参加了一个下午茶。
And this young woman said, Sandy, I've heard that you can interpret dreams.
然后呢，就有一个年轻的女士来问我说，我听说你可以解梦。
And I said, oh, the Holy Spirit does that.
然后我说，哦，是圣灵的工作。
But I'll hear your dream if you'd like to share it.
但是如果你愿意分享的话，我很愿意听你的梦。
And she said, "Oh, it's just a short dream."
她说只是个很短的梦。
And she said, "I'm 3 years old."
她说我三岁。
And I'm in a car with my family.
我在车子里面跟着我的家人一起。
And this huge wave comes up and crashes over the car.
然后呢，就一个很大的浪来压碎了我们的车。
And so I simply ask her, "Honey, what happened when you were 3?"
那我就很简单地问她说，亲爱的，你三岁的时候发生了什么事？
And she said, "That's when my grandfather started to molest me."
她说那就是我的祖父开始在那个时候性侵害我。
We were in a tea party.
我们在一个下午茶。
And I said, "Honey, when I get home, I'll call you."
然后我就说，那等我回家之后，我打电话给你。
And we'll pray this through.
然后我们就一起祷告。
So again, the magnificence of God.
所以再度神的荣耀，他的巨大
，that we can pray for one another over a distance。
我们可以有，就算有距离，我们还是可以为彼此祷告。
Skype is wonderful.
Skype 真的是很棒。
Our trauma can manifest in nightmares。
我们的创伤可以是透过梦魇
，or the lack of dreams，
或者是缺乏梦。
I was at a dream interpretation booth。
我在一个解梦的一个摊位。
It was evangelism outreach.
那是一个传福音的外展机会。
And this young man came in and sat down.
然后有一个年轻男人就过来坐下来。
And I asked him, "Have you had a dream?"
我就问他说，你有做梦吗
？And he said, "No."
他说没有。
So I said, "Well, why are you here?"
那我就问他说，那你来这里做什么呢？
And he said, "Oh, I'd like to know why I've stopped dreaming."
是我想要知道我为什么停止做梦了。
That's a good question.
这是个好问题。
And so I just asked him.
所以我就问他
，When did you stop dreaming?
你什么时候停止做梦的
？And he thought for a while, and he says, "When I was 7 years old."
他说想了一会儿之后，他说七岁的时候吧。
And I simply asked him, "What happened to you when you were 7?"
那我就问他说，那你七岁的时候发生了什么事？
And he said, "That's when I walked in and saw that my father had hung himself."
那就是我走进房间时候看到我的父亲上吊自尽了。
My pastor and I were, we just sat there like.
我的牧师跟我就坐在那边目瞪口呆。
And my pastor recovered faster than me.
我的牧师比我快恢复过来。
And she said, "Sandra knows a little bit about praying to release trauma."
然后他就说 ，Sandra。知道一些小小关于这个为创伤祷告的事情。
Can we pray for you?
我们可以帮你祷告吗
？And he was so thankful.
他非常的感恩。
You know, we need to be prepared.
我们需要准备好。
We don't have to have all the answers.
我们不需要拥有所有的答案。
Or to be an expert.
或者是要成为一个专家。
I'm not an expert.
我不是一个专家。
But you know what? I can love.
但是我可以爱。
And I can be available.
我也是随时准备好的。
And I do my part,
然后我做我的
and the Holy Spirit shows up,
然后圣灵会出现
and does His part,
他就做他要做的事
Extremely traumatic events,
非常极端的创伤事件
release a torrent of stress hormones, searing the memory.
他就会释放很大的荷尔蒙激素，然后烙印在记忆中
Traumatic memory does not decay.
这些极端的创伤事件，它并不会不会衰减
，and nor does it just go away.
它也不会就是离开。
We do a disservice to people.
有的时候我们并没有真正的服侍到人。
To tell them just forget what happened to you and go on.
如果我们告诉他说哦，就忘了你发生了什么事情，往前进吧。
Trust me, we would forget.
相信我，我们会。
If we could,
如果可以的话。
Traumatic memory is stored as raw data.
那这些创伤的记忆呢，就好像是那个资讯一样，储存在我们的脑海里。
And it's stored in a different part of the brain than processed memory.
它是储存在我们的脑海里面不同的地方。
It can manifest as flashbacks.
它有可能是一个影像回应。
Nightmares and haunting memories.
它有可能是噩梦、梦魇。
And the flashbacks are often considered the most debilitating.Fruit of trauma.
但是通常会看到回顾到之前发生事件那个影像，通常是让我们造成最大的压力跟创伤的。
7 million people in America have post-traumatic stress disorder.
在美国有700万人，他们有那个创伤后回应压力的心理障碍症。
And scientists have been trying to help.
那些科学家呢，研究者，他们都很想要帮忙。
And they've discovered something that they call memory blocking drugs.
然后他们呢，就发现一些事情，一些药物叫做就是可以垄断记忆的药物
，or memory dampening drugs，
或者是就是减少你的记忆的药物。
And this is the theory.
这个就是他们的理论。
If I'm raped，
如果我被强暴了。
Or something terrible happens.
或是有些很可怕的事情发生在我身上。
They'll give me the they'll bring up the memory.
他们会把这个记忆呼唤起来。
And give me this medication.
然后把这个药给我。
So the memory will not be able to be restored.
所以这样子呢，这个记忆就不可以再重新的回到我的。
It'll be blocked.
因为它会被阻隔。
Or if it's a past trauma.
或者是它是个过去的创伤
，They'll talk about the trauma.
他们可以谈论一下关于这个创伤
，Bring up emotion.
然后把这个情绪带上来
，And when the emotion is brought up,
当这个情绪上来的时候
，Administer the drug.
给他吃药
，So the memory will not be able to be restored.
然后呢，这个记忆就不可以再回到我们的身上。
And it sounds good.
听起来很不错
，But we know that conscious memory.
但是我们知道我们的有意识的记忆。
Is not the only way that we remember.
不是唯一记得事情的方法。
And so, if our conscious memory is blocked,
如果说我们的有意识记忆被阻隔了
our body still will try and manifest.
我们的身体还是试着会去彰显
The memory will still try to work itself out.
这些记忆呢，还是会自己会想办法要出来的
God does not take away our memories.
神不会拿去我们的记忆。
John Sanford says this.
John 三德福说，我们都有一些想忘掉的过去，也有些往事更是不堪回想。耶稣不会夺去我们的回忆。若是我们失去了我们的记忆，我们就失去了我们一半的智慧。
God does not take away our memory.
神不会拿去我们的记忆。
He does not remove our experience.
他也不会挪去我们的经历。
We don't pretend it didn't happen.
我们不需要假装什么事都没有发生过。
We don't deny something happened.
我们也不否认事情有发生过。
God is a God of truth.
神是神，真理的神。
And he wants truth in our inmost being.
他要我们在心灵最深处都是有真理的。
God does not change history.
神也不会改变历史。
But he does change history's effect.
但是他会改变历史对我们的影响。
God does not block the restorage of the memory.
但是呢，神也不会阻碍我们的记忆恢复。
Oh, God does something far greater.
神要做的事情是更大、更伟大、更美好的。
He brings healing and transformation. Amen.
他会带来医治和转化。Amen.
So instead of blocking the memory,
所以与其是阻断记忆
，we activate the memory.
我们要启动这些记忆。
We talk about it.
我们谈论它。
But we let the person and the Holy Spirit set the pace.
但是我们让那个人还有圣灵决定我们的步骤脚步。
Some people aren't ready to talk.
有些人他们没有准备好要谈论。
Or they'll share this much.
或是他们会分享这么一点。
And that's okay.
那也可以。
We give the Holy Spirit permission to reveal things that may have been forgotten.
我们给圣灵允许让他提醒我们一些也许曾经遗忘的事情。
We validate the pain and emotions.
但是我们认同说这是有痛苦的。
I went to a three-day training.
我经过一个三天的训练。
And I don't remember anything else about the training.
然后在那个记忆，我其实真的不记得任何所有的训练。
Except this.
除了这个。
Validate, validate, validate.
要去认同，去认同，去认同。
And that has served me well.
这真的有对我很大的帮助。
We honor the person.
我们尊荣那个人。
We honor the heart.
我们尊荣他的心。
We honor the emotions.
我们尊荣他的情绪。
And we love people to life.
我们要爱这个人，把他生命爱回来。
It's not about fixing people.
不是关于修理人。
It's about loving people to life.
这是关于要把他爱出他们的生命。
We validate the pain.
我们认同他的痛苦。
But remember, we don't have to experience all of the pain.
但是我们并不需要再次去经历所有的痛苦。
God does not re-traumatize you so that you can be healed from trauma.
神不会要因为要医治你的创伤而再度加创伤在你身上。
Remember in Isaiah 53,
记得在以赛亚书
it says, surely he took up our infirmities.
他说很明确的他背负着我们所有的痛苦。
And surely he carried our sorrows.
诚然的，他担当我们的忧虑，背负我们的痛苦。
So we invite Jesus to step into that window of opportunity.
所以我们就是邀请耶稣来到那个机会之窗。
God created time.
神创造了时间。
So he's not confined to time.
所以他不被时间所控制、限制。
So if I invite the Holy Spirit to go back to that time when I was molested,
所以如果当我邀请圣灵回到我之前被性侵害的时候
and to heal that little girl part of my heart,
去医治那一个小女生的部分的心
do you think he can do that?
你想他可以这样做吗
Yeah. Yes, he can.
是的，他可以的。
So he comes into that window of opportunity.
所以他会进到那个机会之窗
and we pray healing.
然后我们就祷告医治。
For the release of the shock,
为了释放那个震惊
release of the trauma,
释放那个创伤
to release of the fear and terror,
去释放那个恐惧和害怕
and release of the shame,
去释放那个羞愧
from every place that it is settled,
从他在身体中每一个部位
within the body, the soul, or the spirit,
就在我们的身体里面，我们的魂里面，还有我们的灵里面。
It is so important that your heart be healed.
但是很重要，你的心要得医治。
Jesus came to heal the brokenhearted.
耶稣来是要医治那些心灵破碎的人。
But it is also important.
但是同样的也很重要的。
to examine how we've responded to what has happened to us.
去检视说我们如何的去应对那些发生的事情。
Have we forgiven?
我们有原谅了吗？
Are we bitter?
还是我们有苦毒？
Have we judged?
我们有论断吗？
Have we been in that place of self-protection?
我们有要到自我保护吗？
Or pain avoidance?
或者是要逃避痛苦吗？
The alcohol, the drugs, the relationships,
酒精、药品那些关系
the food,
食物
the coffee,
咖啡
the chocolate,
那个巧克力
all of those things that we run to try and feel better, amen.
那些所有我们痛苦的时候，我们就会奔向那些东西，让它要对我，让我们好过一点的 ，amen.
And so we bring those things to death on the cross.
所以我们就把那些东西都钉死在十字架上
And we patiently work through the layers.
然后我们就很有耐心的去一层一层的来解决它
It's kind of like an onion skin. You take off a layer.
就好像那洋葱一样，你剥了一层皮
And there's another layer.
然后又再有一层
And you take off another layer.
然后再剥一层
There's like another one.
然后又还有一个
Am I not done yet?
哦，还没完吗
Be patient.
要有耐心
It's a process.
是一个过程
And for years, I couldn't say the word process.
很多年来我都没有办法讲
I'm serious.
过程这个字，我是很认真的
Process.
我会讲说过程
It sounds different.
听起来很不一样
I couldn't say it in Chinese or in English.
我中文也不能讲，我英文也不能讲
It was like, show me the goal and I'll get there.
他就想说，你告诉我那目标，我就去吧。
I want to be healed and I want to be healed now.
他说我想要被医治，我现在就要得医治。
But God is so gentle.
但神是非常温柔的。
And you know, He takes us step by step because He loves us.
因为他很爱我们，所以他只会带着我们一步接着一步的。
And when healed and restored,
当我们被医治也被恢复的时候。
Our memories become part of our testimony.
我们的记忆就成为我们的见证的一部分。
Part of our overcoming.
哦，见证到说我曾经克服了什么。
It becomes part of our testimony.
它就会变成我们见证的一部分。
是的，我真实的相信，一切的创伤呢都可以得着医治，我们是可以得着恢复，而且得着自由的。我们的世界呢，它不是一个完全的世界。它不只是不完全的，而且是一个充满罪的一个地方。我们周遭的人有罪，我们自己也是有罪。我们彼此会伤害之外呢，我们还会伤害别人。但是它不代表着说我们一直要保留着那样子的一个创伤。可能呢，你自己都不知道你已经受创了。但是求主帮助我们，不只是可以去承认它，更重要的一件事情是得着医治。你知道吗？我们的神呢，他是医治者。他可以真正的帮助我们可以得着完全的医治我们不需要停留在里面但是他最重要的第一步是你要愿意说我愿意去面对他你愿意去承认他把我们真实的情况摆在光下求主帮助我们好不好我带你一起有一个祷告亲爱的父神当我们一起来到主你的面前的时候主啊跟着所有的这个观众朋友们我们的弟兄姐妹我们交在主你的手中主我们何等需要亲爱的圣灵这时候你光照我们每一个人主你帮助我们真实的去看见主啊甚至那些的伤害是我们自己都不愿意去触碰的主啊恳求这时候主你光照我们让我们可以看见主啊让我们愿意真的是把它摆在主你的面前恳求主你来医治主我们愿意把它都交在主你的面前因为你是全能的医治者主谢谢主你爱我们主啊你的心意是要我们得着释放主啊不只看见我们的问题我们要得着医治我们得着释放主我们感谢你把众弟兄姐妹交在主你的手中愿主你的手亲自按在每一个人身上使他得医治感谢赞美你这样祷告奉主耶稣基督你宝贵的圣名阿们我们的主他是全能的医治者愿神祝福你今天得着完全的医治
Why do we pursue healing?
我们为什么要追求医治？
When we hear our song over and over and over again,
当我们听到我们自己的生命之歌不断的重复的时候，
we embrace the truth of who we are.
我们会拥抱我们是谁的真理。
When I was a little girl, I grew up on a farm in Montana.
当我是一个小女孩的时候呢，我是在美国的 Montana 州的一个农场上长大的。
And so I had a younger sister named Ginger.
所以我有一个小妹妹，她的名字叫 Ginger.
And she was blonde-haired and quite pudgy.
她是金发，而且有点胖胖的。
She was very cute little girl.
她是很可爱一个小女生。
And so one day I was looking out the kitchen window.
所以有一天呢，我从厨房的窗户看出去。
And I saw Ginger running.
我就看到 Ginger 在跑。
And she was running so fast.
她跑得很快。
And I've never seen her run that fast before.
我还从来没有看她跑得这么快过。
And then as she was running, she jumped the fence.
然后她跑跑跑，她就跳过那个栏杆。
And I was so impressed.
然后我非常的非常的觉得很讶异。
And I thought, wow.
然后我说哇，好棒。
But then I looked behind Ginger.
然后我就看到 Ginger 的后面。
And there was a big black bear chasing her.
然后有一个大黑熊正在追她。
So that's why she was running so fast.
所以那是为什么她跑得这么快。
You know, our body is designed to respond to stressful situations.
我们的身体呢，被设计就是碰到有压力的情形之后会有反应的。
And it's a wonderful gift of God.
它真的是神给我们很棒的礼物。
And when we're in difficult situations,
当我们在很困难的状况的时候，
you know, because of the adrenaline and all the chemicals,
因为有那个肾上激素啊，还有所有的化学作用，
we're stronger,
我们更强壮，
and faster,
我们更快，
we can think more clearly,
我们可以想得更清楚。
And actually, it's a way that helps us survive.
那实际上呢，它是能帮助我们生存的方法。
But God did not design.
但是神并没有设计
our bodies to be under continual stress.
但是他并没有设计让我们的身体是一直不断的接受
continual fear,
或是一直有害怕。
One of the major fruits of unresolved trauma,
的一个未处理过的创伤的一个果子
is fear and anxiety,
就是恐惧和焦虑。
In fact, anxiety is one of the most toxic emotions we can have.
其实焦虑呢，是我们所有的情绪里面是最带有毒性的。
Dr. Carolyn Leaf
有一位医生叫 Carolyn Leaf.
In her book Who Switched Off My Brain,
她有一本书叫做《谁把我的脑袋关掉了》。
Says this about fear.
她对恐惧有这样说：恐惧是压力的根源，并且恐惧是一个非常真实的灵界的力量。当恐惧进入我们的心思意念，你会经历到心理上的变化。这变化影响直到细胞的细微层面，以至于压力就造成细胞有负面性和伤害性的改变。
Panic attacks,
那些焦虑的发作。
Worrying,
忧虑。
Ruminating,
反复深思。
Can all be fruit of unresolved trauma,
都可能是来自于未处理过的创伤的果子。
When something bad happens to us,
当有一些坏的事情发生在我们身上
，Oftentimes we ruminate，
通常我们就会反复的
think about it，
反复的深思想它
，over and over and over again，
重复又重复，一再又一再的。
And sometimes it includes，
它有的时候会包括
，I should have said that，
我应该要这样讲。
Oh， if only I would have said that，
啊，我要早知道我这样说了。
And we just keep it alive, don't we? And we feed on it almost.
然后我们就会让它一直的运转，好像其实是燃烧，它继续燃烧着一样。
This can be destructive fruit of unresolved trauma.
这个呢，可以是一个非常没有建设性的果子。
And there's an interesting thing that I learned almost by accident.
然后有一件事情呢，我几乎是意外的学习到的。
Thanks, Holy Spirit.
感谢圣灵。
People were coming with panic attacks.
那有些人他们来找我，他们有那个忧虑发作。
And so I was doing a lot of study about panic.
所以我就做了很多的学习关于那个忧郁发作。
And I looked up the word panic.
然后我就查这个字。
And realized that it comes from the root word pan, P-A-N.
然后我就发现它的根源字根其实叫 P-A-N.
And Pan was a Greek.God, small g.
然后呢，其实这个 Pan 叫 Pan 的这个呢，是一个希腊的小神。
That inhabited lonely places.
他住在很孤寂的地方。
And struck fear in the hearts of the shepherds.
然后呢，他就是把恐惧呢升植在那些牧羊人的身上。
And had to do with sexual orgies.
然后呢，这是跟性极交有关系的。
And so I just began asking questions.
所以我就开始问一些问题。
And I would ask people who would come two questions.
然后那些来找我的人，我就问他两个问题。
Were you lonely as a child?
但是当你是孩子的时候，你很寂寞吗？
And did you suffer from sexual abuse?
还有你是不是有被性侵害过？
And in my experience,
在我所经历中，
it's been 100%.
是百分百的。
So oftentimes with panic attack,
所以很通常他们有这些忧虑发作的人，
there is an influence of this demon.
他是有被这个邪灵魔鬼被影响的。
And at first I kind of thought, oh, it was just a Greek myth.
那时候一开始我只想说，哦，这只是个希腊的神话。
But I went to my friend's house after he had been to Israel.
那呢，我的朋友从以色列回来之后呢，我去了他家。
And he was showing slides.
然后他就给我放影片。
And he had one, and he said, "And this is where they worship the Greek god Pan."
然后呢，在他的幻灯片里面，他就讲说，这个是他们在那边敬拜希腊神 Pan 的地方。
And I said, "They still worship him."
我说他们还在敬拜他吗？
And he said, "Yes, it's very common there."
然后说是啊，在那边是非常普遍的。
And so again, this is just a key.
所以再度的，这只是一个关键。
And just ask questions.
就是要问问题。
It may not be.
可能不是
but if the person was very lonely as a child,
但是如果这个人当他小孩的时候是很孤单的
and if they experienced sexual abuse,
而且如果他经历了性侵害
and were very terrified,
然后是非常的害怕恐惧
there could be a foothold that's been given,
有可能他那边是有一个引垒
to this demon,
是给这个魔鬼邪灵 站脚的地方。
And so you pray for the person the healing of the trauma.
所以你帮这个人祷告去医治他的创伤。
And just ask questions, why were you so lonely?
然后就问问题说为什么你孩子的时候这么的孤单？
Were you taken care of?
有人照顾你吗？
Did you have family?
你有家人吗？
Just ask questions and the whole picture will come out.
就是不断的问问题，然后你就会看见整体的图像。
Irritability and restlessness is common fruit.
那些很容易受到刺激、焦躁不安，这也是一个很普遍的果子。
I learned in Singapore.
我在新加坡的时候学习到
that the Chinese word for busy is actually made of two. Is it ideograms?
我是学习到那个中国字里面那个忙这个字其实是两个形象字
for death and heart.
是死亡跟心。
And so many times in our busyness.
所以很多时候在我们很忙碌的时候
in our striving,
然后在我们要去努力
in our inability to rest,
在我们无法休息
something within our heart dies,
在我们心中某个地方某个东西会死去
You know, God lamented that his people could not enter into his rest.
因为神其实他常常非常的难过他的人没有办法进入到他的安息里
And so many years later,
这么多年之后
His people still cannot enter into his rest.
他的人们还是没有办法进入到他的安息里。
There can be feelings of helplessness.
他有可能感觉到非常的无助。
Being out of control.
完全是无法控制的。
And an increased need to try and control.
然后试图掌控所有的事情。
Now we try to control ourselves through perfectionism.
我们透过自我完美主义者要控制我们自己。
If I'm perfect and do everything perfectly, I'll be safe.
我如果是完美的，我做每一件事情都是完美的执行的话呢，我就会很安全的。
Or we try and control other people，
或者是我们想要控制别人。
Don't look at your neighbor，
不要看你旁边的人。
Or we try and control our environment，
或者我们是要掌控我们的环境。
A military veteran，
有一个军人，退伍军人
，will usually not sit with their back to a door or a window，
他们通常不会。背对着门或者是窗户
They work very hard to keep their environment safe
因为他们很努力的要让他们的环境是很平安的
Eating disorders can have roots in unresolved trauma
那些饮食上的不正常它有可能是会有创伤的根的
anorexia and bulimia
的厌食症，还有暴食症
，and obsessive compulsive disorder，
还有那个 OCD， 就是随时要控制重复一件事情很多次的。
Now we know that this is a biological disorder，
我们知道这个是个生理上的疾病
，but it can have roots，
但是它也有可能有根源
，and often does，
它通常都是有根的
，in unresolved trauma，
这根来自于未处理的创伤。
There was a young woman that I worked with，
我之前有跟一位年轻的女士工作
，and she was very obsessive compulsive，
她非常的 OCD，
she counted all the time。
她一直要不断地去数数。
If she went to the store, she couldn't buy two items, she had to buy three.
如果她去一个店里面，她不能够只买两样东西，她一定要买三样东西。
Her closets had to be arranged in a certain way.
她的衣橱一定要照某种特别的方式来安排。
She slept with a knife.
她睡觉的时候会拿着一把刀。
She couldn't do dishes.
她没有办法洗碗。
Because everything had to be done in a certain way.
因为每做一件事情都是一定要有它特定的顺序跟方法。
She couldn't do laundry because she couldn't mix the colors.
她没有办法洗衣服，因为她没有办法把不同的颜色放在一起。
She had been in a mental institution.
她之前有进过精神病院。
And released when she was 21 years old.
她是21岁时候才被释放出来。
With 6 medications.
要吃6种药。
And this prognosis.
还有这样子的一个诊断。
This is what they said.
他们是这样说
You will probably never be able to hold down a job.
他说你永远没有办法，你可能永远没有办法有一份工作。
You'll never be able to live a normal life.
你没有办法生活一个正常的生活方式。
And you probably shouldn't marry.
你也许不应该要结婚。
And just all these negative things spoken over her.
就是他们对他说了一些非常负面的话。
And so when I began to develop relationship with her,
当我开始跟她建立关系的时候
it was very difficult.
是很困难的
She had been wounded by quote unquote Christian counselors.
因为她被那些括号里面的基督徒辅导员所伤害了
So I took a full year just developing relationship.
我花了一整年只是跟她建立关系
And finally we began to pray.
到最后我们终于开始祷告了。
And at one point, I simply asked the Lord, Lord, when did life feel so out of control?
我中间呢，我就问说，主啊，对他来说，什么时候开始生命的如此的失控？
That's a good question to ask.
这是一个很好的问题。
When did life first feel out of control?
生命从何时开始第一次感觉到完全失控？
And she said, "Oh, when I was 12 years old."
她说，哦，我大概十二岁的时候吧。
I was an Olympic hopeful in swimming.
我在游泳里面，他们说我是可以去参加奥运的。
But my coach molested me.
但是因为我的教练性侵害我。
And I just lost desire to swim.
然后我就失去了想要游泳的愿望。
I can remember being in the kitchen, and everything had to be just so.
然后我记得在厨房里面，我就看到每一件东西都得要是有一定的方法。
She lost her dream.
她失去了她的梦想。
And her life fell apart.
她的生命就破裂了。
But I knew that 12 years old was quite old actually for the root.
但其实是我知道说到你12岁的时候呢，你有这个根其实已经是蛮大了的。
But we prayed it through.
但是我们
honored her heart.
我们尊荣她的心。
And she got healing.
然后她就有得到医治。
And then later, we asked the Lord.
然后等一会儿我们又再问神。
Lord, when was the first time?
神什么时候是第一次
that her life fell out of control?
她的生命觉得完全失控。
And usually, the major wounding in our life happens before 6 years old.
通常在我们生命中，那个给我们最大创伤的伤痛来自于六岁之前。
Before our personality is fully formed,
在我们的人格个性还没有完全培养成之前
，so she had a memory.
所以她有一个记忆
of being carried down the stairs by her father.
被她的爸爸抱下楼梯
and he had her as a baby in one arm.
她呢在当作是一个 baby 在她的一个手背里
and a gun in the other.
她的另外一只手上拿着一把
枪 and he was arguing with his wife.
他在跟他的太太吵架
，and threatening to kill the baby.
然后呢，就威胁说要把这个女儿杀掉。
Life was out of control.
生命完全失控。
Authority was out of control.
权威权柄也完全失控。
And dad had to leave the home.
那爸爸呢得要离家。
Mom went to work.
那妈妈就去上班。
She was all alone.
她是完全的孤单的。
Life was out of control.
生命完全失控。
They didn't have very much to eat.
他们没有很多食物可以吃。
Mom started bringing men home.
妈妈就开始带一些男人回家。
And the men would go to her bedroom.
然后那些男人会进到她的房间。
Life was out of control.
生命完全失控。
And so I said, listen to your heart.
所以我就跟他说，聆听你的声音。
How did you judge authority?
你如何的对权威权柄有论断？
Authority won't protect me.
因为那些权威没有办法保护我。
What did you come to expect?
那你期望什么呢？
I'll be abused.
我会被虐待。
I'll be hurt.
我会被伤害。
I might die.
我可能会死。
So what did you decide?
所以你决定了什么？
I'd have to protect myself.
我得要保护我自己。
I have to be strong.
我得要很坚强。
I have to make my life safe.
我要让我的生命是安全的。
How did you judge life?
那你对于生命有什么论断？
Life is out of control.
生命是失控的。
Life is scary.
生命是可怕的。
How'd you protect yourself?
那你怎么保护你自己呢？
I had to take control.
我得要有控制。
So everything that she did from that point on was to try and keep her world safe.
那从那些时候开始，她所做的每一件事情都是要让她生命是安全的。
But what little girl can keep her world safe?
但是有哪一个小女生可以让她的世界是变得很安全的呢？
And she had all these rituals and formulas.
就她有很多的仪式啊、形式跟方程式。
But she was a prisoner.Inside her fear.
但实际上呢，她是在她的恐惧里面被囚的囚犯。
It took a while.
那花了一段时间。
Remember the word process?
你记得我刚讲的过程。
But she got free.
但是她得自由了。
She went to Elijah House Schools.
她去了以利亚之家的学校。
The last I heard, she was working two jobs.
我之前听到是她有两份工作。
And loving the Lord.
很爱主。
What the world would say, this is hopeless.
当世界告诉你说这个是完全没有希望的。
Or this is without cure.
这是没有办法医治的。
Don't listen to it.
不要去听他的。
We have a God that is a God of the impossible.
我们有一个神，他可以使不可能变成可能的。
Amen.
Amen.
Outbursts of anger and rage and aggressiveness.
爆发愤怒、暴怒、攻击性。
And you know why we pursue inner healing?
你知道为什么我们要追寻内在医治吗？
Because hurt people hurt people.
因为伤痛的人会去伤害别人。
Wounded people wound people.
有带着伤的人会去伤害别人。
And it's not so much about us.
其实不是关于我们自己。
We pursue healing so that we stop hurting people.
我们追求医治，所以这样子我们可以去停止伤害别人。
So that we can manifest God well.
所以我们能够正确的能彰显神。
When we're in church and everything's fine.
当我们在教会里的时候，每一件事情都很好。
But also at home.
但是在家。
Where it really counts.
在家才是真算数的地方。
On the freeway.
在高速公路上。
And on the streets.
在街上。
Amen.
Amen 吗？
We can either act out through anger and aggressiveness.
我们要不然呢，就是要透过愤怒来。
Or we act in with withdrawal and isolation.
或者是我们会往内在呢，就会开始退缩，然后呢远离。
I was always the righteous one.
我一直都是那个很正确的人。
I didn't get angry and slam doors.
我并没有生气然后甩门。
But I withdrew and isolated.
但是呢，我就会退缩，然后我就会隔离自己。
Sin is sin.
罪就是罪。
Whether we act out or we act in.
不管我们是展现出来或者是内设
Emotional numbing or restricted range of feelings
情绪上麻木或者只能有限度的感觉
When emotions are blocked or denied they become extremely toxic
当我们的情绪呢是被阻隔的是被否定的时候呢他们其实会变成非常有毒性的
There's no such thing as an unexpressed emotion
没有所谓的未被表达的情绪
If we don't express it appropriately
我们如果没有正确的去表达它
It'll come out sideways
它就会从别的地方出来
How many of you have been at work
你们有多少人在工作的场合
？And you've been so angry at your employee.
你对你的老板非常的生气
，or at your employer，
或者是对你的哦，对你的同事，或者是对你的老板。
But you couldn't say anything.
但是你什么都不能说。
So you come home and slam the door.
所以你回到家你就摔门。
And yell at your spouse.
或是对着你的妻子或先生大吼。
It comes out sideways sometimes, doesn't it?
他们有的时候会从侧边出来的，不是吗？
Sometimes we can have emotional swings.
所以有的时候我们的情绪摇摆幅度很大。
And we can get stuck in ages of emotional immaturity.
然后我们就可能就会卡在很久的卡在那个情绪上的不成熟。
I was ministering to an older couple.
我之前呢在对一对夫妻服侍。
And the wife said, sometimes he acts like a three-year-old.
然后那个太太说，他有的时候行为像一个三岁的小孩一样。
And I just turned to him.
我就是转向那个先生。
He said, what happened when you were three?
我就说你三岁的时候发生了什么事。
It's true.
是真的。
Sometimes we get stuck in areas of our heart.
有的时候我们在心里面呢就会困在一个地方。
In that age of immaturity.
在那个不成熟的年龄。
When the trauma happened.
当创伤发生的时候。
Have you seen adults act like 5 years old?
你有看过成人他的行为举止像五岁的吗
？16-year-old
像十六岁的。
Ask some questions. What happened?
问他们一些问题，发生了什么事
？It could be that there's a part of their heart.
有可能他们心的一部分
that's stuck in that age.
就卡在那个年龄里。
And when we're triggered,
当我们被勾起来的时候
，or when that familiar pain happens，
或是那个很熟悉的痛再度发生的时候
，instead of acting out of that mature place of our heart，
如果不是从我们很成熟的心的地方来发展
，we go into that immaturity，
我们就会走到那个不成熟的地方
，disconnecting，
不连接
，we can disconnect from emotions，
我们可以从我们的情绪里不连接它。
I was the queen of this.
我曾经是那个皇后。
I'm not going to cry.
我不要哭。
I'm not going to feel.
我不要去感觉。
I'm not going to need people.
我不要需要人。
I'm not going to let people hurt me that way again.
我不要让人他们再用那种方法伤害我。
And I disconnected over and over and over again from my feelings.
我就把我的跟我的感觉完全的不连接。
We can disconnect from people.
我们可以跟人不连接。
From reality.
从现实中不连接。
Live in our own little fantasy.
活在我们自己的梦想世界里。
Our own little world.
我们自己的小小的世界。
We can even disconnect from ourselves.
我们甚至可以跟自己都开始不连接。
And when there's overwhelming trauma.
当有很我们无法所承担的创伤的时候。
Oftentimes people will actually disconnect from themselves.
通常他们会跟自己不连接。
And other personalities are developed.
所以他会开始发展另外一个人格个性。
Personalities that deal with the trauma.
会让这个个性来去面对那个创伤。
And so that's a complicated issue.
它是个很复杂的话题。
But I really encourage you to study it out.
但是我真的很鼓励你去学习它。
Because if you minister to trauma, you will experience this.
因为你如果你是服侍创伤事工的话，你会经历到这些事情的。
And it's good just to know what's happening.
那是很好的，如果你只知道说这发生了什么事情。
Cutting and scarring is another fruit of unresolved trauma.
自残割伤造成疤痕也是另外一个创伤的果子。
When I was in the UK, an 11-year-old girl came to me.
我在英国的时候，有一个十一岁的女孩来找我。
And her arms looked like a hamburger.
然后她的手臂看起来像汉堡一样。
And I just looked at her, I looked in her eyes.
我就看着她，我看进她的眼睛里。
And I said, honey, what hurts?
我就跟她说，亲爱的，什么真是让你痛
？And this little girl just melted in my arms.
这个小女生就在我的怀抱里融掉。
And cried and cried and cried.
就哭啊哭啊哭的。
We don't have to have all the answers.
我们并不一定要拥有所有的答案。
We just have to know how to love.
我们只是要知道怎么去爱。
Difficulty concentrating or remembering directions.
难以注意力集中或者是记住方向。
And this was me. I would get lost so easily.
这个就是我，我那时候曾经很容易就会迷路迷失。
Actually, I got lost in New Zealand on a hunting trip.
其实呢，我在纽西兰的时候呢，我去打猎的时候，我也走失了。
And that's a whole different story.
那是个完全不同的故事。
It's actually quite funny.
其实还蛮好笑的。
Wasn't so much at the time.
但当时不是很好笑。
Depression is another common fruit.
忧郁是另外一个果子。
And shame and self-blame.
羞耻还有自我责备。
A woman came up to me at a seminar.
有一个女士在我的课程的时候来找我
and said, "When I was 21, I had an abortion, and she began to cry."
她说，当我二十一岁的时候呢，我有堕胎。讲完之后，她就开始哭了。
And I said, "Honey, have you confessed?"
然后我说，亲爱的，你有认罪吗
？And she said, "A million times."
她说，一百万次了。
I said, "Do you feel forgiven?"
那我就问她说，你有感觉到你被饶恕吗？
Have you been able to forgive yourself?
你有原谅你自己吗
？And she said, "No. How could I be forgiven?"
她说怎么可能？我不可能原谅我。
How could I forgive myself?
我怎么可以原谅我自己呢
？And I just said, "You know, it seems noble to say that."
她说，我就跟她说
，I can't forgive myself.
听起来好像是非常崇尚的，你不能够原谅你自己。
But what you're saying is that Jesus did enough for everybody else.
但是你实际上你所表达的是耶稣他为别的人都做了足够的事
but not for you
但是不是为我
and I said have you repented she said yes
我就问他说你有认罪吗他说有啊
and so I said the very moment that you confessed
我说当你在认罪的那个当下
you were forgiven
已经被原谅了
so what you've carried for all those years is not guilt
所以这么多年来，你一直所带着的呢，不是罪恶感。
Guilt did its work; it brought you to the cross.
罪恶感呢，它已经达到了它的目的，它把你带到十字架前。
What you've been feeling all these years is shame.
你这么多年来一直感受到的是羞愧。
And so we prayed and asked the Lord to remove the trauma.
所以我们就祷告了，请求主来挪去他那个创伤
，and to remove the shame.
然后去挪去他的羞耻。
And she was set free.
然后她就得自由了。
Guilt and survivor's guilt.
那个罪恶感还有存性幸存者的内疚。
I ministered to a 70-year-old mercenary.
我之前呢有服侍一个七十岁的海军人。
He'd left home at 14.
他十四岁时候就离家。
And had been a mercenary for years and years and years.
他就是很多年来都是去帮不同的国家打仗。
And he put his head in his hands.
他把他的头放在他的手里面。
And he said, "I wish there was a remedy for the guilt that I feel."
他说，我真的希望是有一个能医治我所感受到的内疚感的东西。
I said, "Sir,"
我说先生
"there is a remedy."
这是有一个解药的。
And I shared with him the gospel.
然后我就跟他分享福音。
We carry the good news.
我们所带来的好消息。
And we can help people to come to the cross and to be free.
我们可以帮助人们来到十字架前而得自由。
There was a young man that came back from Iraq.
之前有一个年轻人，他从伊拉克回来。
And he was paralyzed from the waist down.
然后他从腰下就是瘫痪的。
And they couldn't figure out what was wrong with him.
他们也不知道他到底有哪里不对劲。
And so he went to counseling.
所以他就去接受辅导。
And it took a while, but this is what they discovered.
他们花了一些时间，但是他们发觉了。
He was supposed to be the leader of the group that day.
他应该是那一天要带队的领队。
And his friend stepped in front of him.
结果他的朋友站在他的前面。
And was shot.
然后被枪杀了。
And so this young man carried that survivor guilt.
所以这个年轻人呢，他就带着那个存性者的内疚。
It should have been me.
应该是我。
And so that internal conflict.
所以他的内在的挣扎。
That internal paralysis
他的内在的瘫痪
was being manifested externally
所以是变成是在他的身体上所彰显出来
And when he was able to release the guilt
当他能够释放这个罪恶感的时候
He could walk again
他就可以再度走路了
Low self-esteem, identity issues
自卑感、身份认同问题
Gender confusion
那些性别的困惑
Homosexuality,
同性恋
oftentimes have roots in unresolved trauma.
通常他们都是在未处理的创伤中有根源的
Difficulty in relationships,
在关系中有困难的
hard to connect on a heart-to-heart level.
很难跟人有心对心的连结。
Victim mentality.
有受害者的心态。
Repeated prolonged abuse.
有一直重复的延长的虐待。
With no perceived way of escape.
他就完全看不到他有什么办法可以逃脱。
Tempts us to feel like a victim.
让我们感觉到说我们是受害者。
We begin to believe things will never change.
我们就会开始感觉到事情永远不会改变的。
And we begin to believe the lie, I'm a victim.
我们就会开始相信那个谎言，那个谎言就是我是一个受害者。
And if we carry a victim spirit,
如果我们带着是受害者的灵，
we will draw predators.
我们就会变成是掠夺者。
One woman came and she said, if I'm in a room of 50 people,
有一个女士她进来她说如果我在一个房间里面有五十个人
And there's one pervert in that room
那这里面有一个是那个侵害者变态
That person will be drawn to me
那个人呢就会被我所吸引
And she said do I have a mark on me or something
她说我是不是头上戴一个靶标啊
And I said well in a way you do
我对她说某个程度上你是啊
When you were abused as a little girl what did you come to expect?
当你是小女孩你被性侵害的时候你就开始期望了什么
Abuse
就是被虐待、啊、
To be treated like manure
就会被像是粪土一样对待、啊、
And I said you know what those are called bitter expectations
你知道吗那些叫做苦毒的期待
And we draw people to us
我们会吸引那些人来
Not with our head
不是为了因着我们的头
But we're projecting from our spirit
而是从我们的灵里面去展现出来
and from our wounded heart
从我们被受伤的心
and from our sinful response
从我们有罪性的反应
I expect you to reject me
我期待你来拒绝我
and so we draw those people to us
所以我们会吸引那些人来到我们身边
and also when we're sexually abused
还有通常当我们被性侵害的时候
if that person is operating under a spirit of lust
如果那个人是因着有情欲的灵而运作的话
or a spirit of perversion
或是有变态的灵
that spirit can defile us
那个灵会沾污我们
not on the inside
不只是在里面
but it's like we're slimed
就好像我们是全身是被那个黏搭搭的东西而遮盖
and so later on in our life
所以待会在我们人生的的阶段里面
If someone is walking by with that spirit, that same spirit,
如果身边经过的人，他身上也有同样的那种灵
that spirit is drawn to that defilement.
那个灵呢，就会被那个我们身上所沾污的吸引。
And I said, that's the bad news.
我说那个是坏消息。
The good news is this can be healed.
我说这好消息就是它可以得医治的。
The defilement can be easily washed off by the power of the Holy Spirit.
那些你被沾污的地方、肮脏的地方是很轻易的就可以被圣灵给洗干净的。
Because the only mark that you're to carry is the mark of the Holy Spirit of God.
因为你身上所要唯一要带的印记呢是圣灵的印记。
And when we take those bitter expectations to death on the cross,
当我们把那些苦毒的期待钉死在十字架上的时候
you will actually repel predators.
你就会开始排除那些侵略掠夺者。
We begin oftentimes to live as orphans and slaves.
我们很多时候就会开始活得像个孤儿或者是奴隶。
And as survivors.
像一个存性者。
I don't like to use the phrase survivor of sexual abuse.
我不喜欢用这句话说是性侵害的存性者
or a survivor of trauma
或者是创伤的存性者
you won't find that word in the Bible
你在圣经里面是找不到这个字的
what you find is overcomer
你会发现的是得胜者
Christ has called us to overcome
基督呼召我们要去得胜
Amen and so there can be self-destructive or even suicidal behavior.
所以有可能我们会有自我毁灭或甚至有自杀倾向
or even death wishes.
或是死亡的愿望
I learned that a person tries to kill themselves in China every 2 minutes.
我学习到说在中国大陆每两分钟就有一个人会想要自杀夺去自己的生命
It's among the highest rates in the world.
在世界上里面是最高的
That's amazing.
真的是很令人讶异
There can also be spiritual fruit.
也有可能有属灵的果子。
Zephaniah 3:17 says this.
耶和华你的神是施行拯救、大有能力的主，他在你中间必因你欢欣喜乐，默然爱你，且因你喜乐而欢呼。
When God created the world, He released His word.
当神创造这个世界的时候，他就释放了他的话语。
And He said, "Let there be."
他就说让那有。
But I believe that the Lord actually sang the world into being.
但是我觉得神其实一直说出来这个世界。
Even today, rabbis don't just read the word of God; they sing the word of God.
那今天呢？其实连拉伯他们都不只是阅读读圣经，而是他们是唱出圣经。
And I believe that God released His song over the void.
我觉得神呢是把他的歌释放在这个空洞的地方。
And over the darkness,
在那黑暗的地方。
And the Holy Spirit began to brood.
然后呢，圣灵就开始酝酿。
And creation came to be.
然后创造就开始发生。
There's something called sympathetic resonance.
有一些叫做感动的共鸣。
And that means that if I'm playing the guitar loudly,
他说我如果在这边弹吉他，很大声的弹吉他。
And there's a guitar in the corner,
然后在角落上有一个吉他。
That's in the same key,
它是有一个同样的键。
That guitar will begin to vibrate. The strings will begin to vibrate.
那个吉他的弦也会开始震动。
And produce a sound,
然后就会创造发出一个声音。
And I believe that that's the way that we were created.
而且我相信我们就是那样子而被造的。
That we were created to respond to this song of God that He sings over us.
我们呢就是被创造了，我们要来回应神创造我们的时候所唱的歌。
And so whatever is wounded within us, whatever is broken within us,
所以不管在我们内在里面有多么的受伤，多么的破碎
，When we come into agreement with this song, that's where the healing is.
当我们能跟神所唱的歌同心合意的时候呢，我们就能够得着医治。
That's where the miracles are.
那就是神迹所在。
Jesus is light.
主耶稣是光。
And when He brings His light into our darkness,
当他把他的光带进了我们的黑暗当中。
When He brings His light into our woundedness,
当他把他的光带进了我们的伤痛之中。
We begin to respond to Him.
我们就会开始回应他。
We begin to vibrate with the frequencies of God.
我们就开始跟神的频率一起开始震动。
And we begin to heal.
我们就开始医治。
However, trauma is like a blow to us.
但是呢，创伤是像我们一个对有一个重重的打击。
Do you remember those old-fashioned radios?
你还记得那古老的收音机吗
？Where you turn the dial and get a station?
然后你要转才能够收到那个收音机的台吗
？But if you drop the radio,
如果你不小心摔了那个收音机
，you might get an altogether different station.
你可能就会得到一个完全不同的电台。
And that's what happens to us when we are traumatized.
这就是实际上这就是发生在我们身上，当我们受到创伤的时候。
We were designed to receive this beautiful song of God.
我们实际上被设计呢是要去来领受神美妙的音乐。
But many times the blow of trauma,
但是很多时候因为创伤的打击
affects our ability to hear and to receive,
影响了我们能够听和接收的能力。
It affects our ability to trust,
它影响了我们能信任的能力。
And we lose a sense of fairness, it's not supposed to be this way.
我们就会失去了一些那个不公平啊，就觉得本来事情不应该是这样的。
And one of my friends asked me, why does the enemy target young children?
然后我有个朋友问我说，为什么我们的仇敌总是要攻击孩子们？
And I don't know the answer to that.
我不知道那个答案。
Except this.
除了这个。
That what we experience as children,
我们孩童的时候所经历的
affect our perceptions and beliefs,
它影响了我们的对事情的看法还有我们的信念。
About everything.
关于每一件事情。
There is often an expectation of doom.
通常呢，我们会期待了有不好的事情发生。
And we begin to see God through the lens of our experience.
那我们就透过我们自己的经验成为一个镜片，用透过这个镜片来看神。
And those bitter judgments against those who abused us.
还有那些对于那些虐待我们、侵害我们的人，我们对他有苦毒的论断。
Instead of the lens of truth.
而不是透过真理的镜片。
And we make those inner vows not to trust, not to be vulnerable, to be tough.
然后我们就会有内在誓言，说让我们自己绝对不能够被侵害，我们要很坚强。
And it affects our intimacy with God and others.
它就会影响了我们跟神的亲密，还有跟人的亲密。
And we shut down our ability to feel and to sense.
我们就完全关闭了我们所有的能力去感受，去感受。
And to experience that glory realm of God.
然后去经历那个神荣耀的境界。
Trauma and relentless disappointment.
那些受伤害
shatters our ability to hope.
破碎了我们能够有盼望的能力。
We're afraid to get our hopes up.
我们很害怕有期盼。
Robert Hicks says,
我的Robert Hicks 说，受创伤的人看不见盼望，而他们却需要盼望才能存活。
And Proverbs 13:12 says,
箴言13-12说，所盼望的延迟未得，无情的打击失望，令人心忧，所愿意的临到却是生命树。
The disappointment leaves us heartsick.
失望会让我们的心忧。
And this affects our faith.
这会影响到我们的信心。
Faith is the substance of things hoped for.
信心是所望之事实的实底。
So if I decide I'm not going to get my hopes up, can I be that woman of faith that I want to be?
所以如果说我决定了我不要有任何的盼望的话，我是否能够成为那个有信心的人？
No, it affects that.
不行啊，因为会影响的。
And we're like an anchor tossed to and fro.
我们就好像是一个锚一样，被丢来丢去的。
We become insecure.
我们没有安全感。
And we're unable to sing our song.
我们就没有办法来唱我们的歌。
I was ministering to a lady, and she had a lot of physical problems.
我之前有服侍一位女士，她有很多身体上的问题。
And when I had my hand on her shoulder.
当我把手放在她的肩膀上的时候
，and I can feel a vibration within her.
我可以感觉到从她体内来的有一些震动。
And I heard a sound like screeching of fingernails on a blackboard.
然后呢，我就听到一个声音，就好像手指甲刮在黑板上的那个尖锐的声音。
And I wondered, God, what is that?
然后就问说，神啊，那是什么？
And so I began doing some research.
所以我就开始做一些研究。
On vibration,
关于震动
and sound,
还有声音
and she'd been through lots of trauma,
她经历了很多的创伤
and of course I came across some New Age articles.
那当然了，我也有看到一些New Age 的一些文章
but I decided to throw that stuff out.
那我就决定了，我把那些都丢出去
and I said, Lord, would you lead me to scientific information?
说主啊，请你带领我到有科学的根据。
Lead me to the truth.
带我到真理。
And I came across a 2001 article.
然后我就是发现了一个2011年的文章。
In the Smithsonian Magazine.
在美国博物馆的一个杂志。
And the title of the article was The Sound That Cells Make.
结果那个文章的标题就是说这个细胞所发出来的声音。
And what they discovered in this article,
他们在这篇文章里面他们所发掘的
in the research that they were doing,
在他们所做的研究里
they would take a cell from a living human heart,
他们会从一个活人的心里面取一些细胞
put it in a petri dish to keep it alive,
放在那个研究的玻璃盆里面然后让它活着
and they realized that the cell continued to pulsate,
然后他们就发现这个细胞它会一直不断的震动
A cell continued to vibrate.
这个细胞不断的震动。
And so they began to ask questions.
他们就开始问问题。
If sound is simply vibration that reaches our ear,
如果说这个声音单纯的只是震动而传到我们的耳朵里
could it be that cells produce sound?
那有没有可能细胞会创造声音？
And so since that time, they've developed something called atomic force microscopes.
自从那个时候呢，他们就发展了一个叫做atomic 的显微镜。
And these microscopes measure the sound that cells make.
这些显微镜呢，他们却可以去衡量量出来这个细胞所发出来的声音。
And so I began to reason.
所以我就开始去思考
，If we're made up of cells，
如果我们是用细胞组成的
，and cells produce a sound，
细胞会发出声音
，Could it be？
那有没有可能
That God's word is true.
神的话语是真的。
Could we actually be a song that responds to the song of God?
我们有可能是一首歌来回应神的歌吗？
So I began to ask questions.
对，我又开始问很多问题。
What's the difference between a sound and a song?
Well, 一个声音跟一首歌有什么不同呢？
Music is sound and movement put in order.
音乐是声音跟律动节奏放在一起排列组成的。
And this order is accomplished by following the rules of music.
这个顺序呢是照着有一些规则来安排的。
Melody,
旋律
,rhythm,
节奏
,harmony,
和音
,and form,
还有形式。
And so when these things come into order,
当这些事情都到了有规律的时候
,it's no longer sound,
它就不再是声音
,but a song,
但是一首歌。
They are doing fascinating research.
他们现在做一些非常令人着迷的一些研究。
Converting DNA sequences to music.
他们可以把 DNA 的顺序变成音乐。
And so we truly are a song.
所以我们真真实实的是一首歌。
But the suddenness and unpredictability of trauma.
但是那些突发事情还有我们无法预料的那些创伤。
Breaks the rules.
砍断了这些的规则。
It affects our harmony, our rhythm.
它就会影响了我们的和声，我们的曲风。
Our form and our timing.
我们的节奏，还有我们的时间。
What they've discovered is that cells under stress.
他们也发觉说，在那些受到压力的细胞
produce a different sound than healthy cells.
他们会发出一些声音，跟那个健康的细胞是不一样的。
And they want to be able to eliminate biopsies altogether.
他们很想要就完全不要做那个不要能够抽样检查
by simply listening to the cells of the body.
他们只要聆听身体里的细胞。
Isn't that amazing?
那不是很神奇吗？
And cancer cells make a screeching sound.
然后癌细胞会发出那种像是黑板指甲在黑板上那种尖锐的声音。
And I went, oh, that's what I was hearing within that woman.
然后我就说啊、oh, 我现在知道了我在那位女士身上所听到的声音就是这个。
Sometimes we can't hear his song because of the pain we feel.
有的时候是因为我们的痛苦我们根本没有办法听到他的歌。
And we're in disharmony.
然后我们完全的是不和谐的。
Discordance and disease.
我们完全是不和谐的然后有疾病的。
Trauma affects our timing.
创伤影响了我们的时机。
And especially when there are sudden deaths of children.
尤其是特别在有孩童突然不幸身亡。
Or children exposed to things before their time.
所以或者是孩子被暴露在说超乎他们经验的成熟度可以理解的事件中。
Or sexuality awakened before its time.
或者是性欲过早被唤醒起来。
Exposure to pornography,
或者是他们是看到了色情刊物
is always, always, always a trauma.
永远永远永远这些都是创伤。
Trauma can affect our ability to flow in the Kairos timing of God.
创伤能影响我们跟随神特定的关键时刻。
And we miss those opportunities and open doors.
我们常常会错过机会或是感觉是临门一脚。
Or we have a sense that we're half a step off.
或是我们总是会感觉我们错了慢半拍。
Or we're clumsy.
或是我们很不协调。
Fatigued, didn't we feel half awake?
我们好像很累然后很笨拙。
We can't seem to find our rhythm of life.
我们根本好像没有办法找到我们生命的韵律。
And trauma can also affect our ability to rest.
创伤也会影响我们安息的能力。
Mrs. Charles Coleman says this.
Charles...夫人她说有什么音符比强调暂停的休止符更伟大呢在休止中虽然没有声音其中却做出音乐
And can you read Matthew 11:28-29 out of the message? Is it there?
马太福音11章28节到29节凡劳苦担重担的人可以到我这里来我就使你们得安息我心里柔和谦卑你们当负我的轭学我的样式这样你们心里就必得享安息
Unforced rhythms of grace
那些神恩典的节奏。
God wants to restore your song，
神要恢复你的歌
，and your ability to flow in His grace，
还有你在他的恩典中运行的能力。
In Hosea 2:15, it says this.
何西阿书2:15说，他从哪里出来，我必赐他葡萄园，又赐他雅各谷作为指望的门，他必在那里应声，或作歌唱，与幼年的日子一样，与从埃及地上来的时候相同。
In the valley of Achor,
在那个雅谷雅各谷
actually means the valley of trouble.
它实际上代表的是有困难的谷。
And God says, I'm going to make it a door of hope.
神说我会把它变成一个希望之门。
And you're going to sing there.
你会在那里歌唱。
So how many of you feel like, you know what, I've lost my song?
你们有多少人觉得说我真的已经失去了我的生命之歌？
There are things that have happened to me that have affected me.
对，有些事情发生它已经影响了我。
And I've lost my song.
我失去了我的歌。
And I want it back.
我想要它回来。
I'm not able to respond to God the way I want to.
我没有办法回应神是我想要回应的方法。
I'm not able to rest the way I want to.
我没有办法想用我休息的方法来休息。
I see some of this fruit in my life that you've mentioned.
我看到你之前提过的这些果子在我的生命中。
And I long to be free.
我很想要得自由。
Is there anyone here and you say, yes, that's me. I want to pray. I want to agree.
你们有没有人在这边说，那是我，我想要祷告，我想要得自由。
I want my song restored.
我要恢复我的生命之歌。
我非常喜欢讲员所说的，我们的生命呢，就像一首诗歌一样。是的，生命之歌。不晓得你的生命里面呢是有什么样子的一个歌呢？它只是发出各式各样的声音跟节奏，还是它真的是一个歌曲，是一个动人的一个声音呢？创伤在我们的生命里面呢，它不是只是说影响我们，或者是它只是造成伤害，它其实影响我们，让我们这个人他得不到真实的一个安息，不止得不到安息，也没有办法真正的活出上帝在我们这个人生命当中的一个命定，他在我们生命当中有美丽的计划，有美丽的一个旨意，只是因为那些的创伤压抑了我们，压制了我们，让我们没办法真正成为神所预定要我们所成就的。亲爱的弟兄姐妹，亲爱的朋友们，不晓得你是否愿意呢？你是否觉得你的生命里面呢，是的，它有声音，但是它是各式各样的噪音，它是各式各样的一个声音呢？你是否愿意真正的活在神的一个心意里面，跟神在你生命当中的一个命定与安排呢？好吧，我们一起来祷告，求主帮助我们，因为他不只可以帮助我们医治我们，他更是可以恢复我们在当初神他创造我们的一个样式。我邀请你跟我一起祷告。亲爱的父神，当我们众人一起来到主你面前的时候，是的，我们不得不承认在过往是有创伤，许多的事情并不是我们愿意的，更何况更多的这些的伤口，这些的伤害不是我们自己造成的，很多时候是我们也不愿意，但是就是这样发生在我们生命里。我们生命里面有许多的无奈，有许多的痛苦，甚至有许多不知道的这些的为什么闷在我们的里面。恳求主你帮助我们，主啊，不止医治我们，谢谢主你让我们有机会可以来到主你的面前，面对我们过往所有一切的创伤，请求主你进入到我们那一切的一个创伤，只有你可以医治，只有你可以帮助我们。主啊，我们要对你在你面前说，主，我们愿意，我们愿意你这时候进到我们里面。主啊，不只是医治我们，主你帮助我们恢复，主你创造我们那个样式，主，孩子不得不在你面前承认，主啊，过往那些的创伤不是只是影响我们，它甚至的过去它也影响我们的未来，让我们没有真正的可以过一个未来是一个充满了光明，充满了喜乐的一个生命。主啊，这时候恳求主，孩子祷告，恳求主你做那释放的工作，医治的工作，更重要的是恩主，请求主你在我们当中做那恢复的工作。 主，让我们得到恢复，让我们的生命里面呢，再一次的充满了歌声，充满了赞美你的声音。主，我们感谢赞美你，谢谢主你与我们同在，谢谢主你垂听祷告。主，我们这样祷告是奉主耶稣基督你最宝贵的圣名。亲爱的弟兄姐妹，我们的神是全能的医治者，祝福你今天得着完全的医治。